Basta sinabi nila na wa na si mama. Sinabi ni tita kong tabunan ng landslide. So umiiyak na lang kami, yung father ko nakatingin nandito. Nakatulala.
In 2006, a landslide destroyed the entire village of Ginsaugon, St. Bernard, Southern Leyte, killing more than 1,000 people instantly. The DEPECO program went to Ginsaugon with the aim to increase resilience and reduce the vulnerability of the communities in disaster-prone areas. This was the program's entry point in the Philippines. The Disaster Preparedness ECHO program, or DEPECO, was formed in 1996 and is at the heart of the disaster risk reduction efforts of the European Commission's Humanitarian Aid and Civil Protection Department. Over the past decade, the DEPECO program partnered with local and national government authorities, United Nations agencies, and civil society organizations, thereby reaching communities in 28 provinces. Throughout the years, a total of €8,739,948 was invested, reaching and changing more than 3 million lives.
Huwag natin sanayin yung sarili natin na matakot para gumalaw. Kasi yung warning, ginawang warning yan para mag-warn. Hindi yan parang cliche lang.
Sana wala nang mangyayaring ganito ba. Kaya panay kami lagay ng extensometers dun sa mga crack. Palagi tayong magre-research, tapos nag-learn from, ay, ito pala yung bago, ito pala yung mga practice doon na papasok natin dito. Para at least naman, wala nang Ginsaugo na mangyari.
When Typhoon Frank hit their municipality in 2008, the local government unit of St. Bernard evacuated all people from flood-prone areas, saving the entire community.
Tahimik dito, masaya. Isa lang problema dito, pag may baha. 19 floods before Bagyo Sindong. We are unprepared. We didn't know what to do. Pan wala may mawala o mutuota. Wa mo po'y mawala o magliok ka. Wa man po'y mawala o mangandam
ka. We try to supply them with yung mga kulang nila mga equipments. If we continue this consistently every year, at least maybe we can make a dent somehow.
In 2014, communities around Banica River were hit by a flash flood caused by Tropical Depression Queenie. Because early warning systems were introduced, 1,400 lives and 1 million pesos worth of properties were saved in just 55 minutes.
Kailangan natin gumawa ng plano para mabuhay tayo ng maayos, kumbaga, kahit may nakaambang panganib. Nagmapa muna kami ng barangay namin, katulad ng sa mangroves area namin na sheltering talaga namin yan. Nung na-present namin is very effective pala. Ang objective natin dito, kung mas makakapag-encourage pa tayo sa practice natin, then makaka-inspire tayo ng ibang communities.
Many remote islands are cut off from communication, electricity, and resources. Small Island Resiliency was formed.
I love this place. Pag mag-warning lang ang LGU for evacuation din, automatic yung mga nasa komunidad na mag-evacuate. Naisabuhay na sa kanila yung pagtutulungan, yung sinabing dahil sa Bayanihan Spirit.
Magagawa kami ng simulation drill. Doon namin i-assist at i-evaluate kung may alam sila sa tinuturo namin o wala. Mahirap yung mawalan tayo ng mga mahal sa buhay at saka bakit hindi namin gagawin yung nararapat gawin sa para sa amin, kababayan.
Reeling from successive large-scale disasters, the Philippines passed Republic Act 10121 in 2010. The law paved the way for DRRM in all tiers of the government, scaling up to the national level, but with an emphasis on local leadership and action.
Kung bilang magsasaka, huwag kang titigil. Tuloy-tuloy. Nung nagtuto ako, na-adapt ako, diversified farming. Yun ang gawin ko ngayon.
Yung climate change, tuloy-tuloy na talaga siya. Kaya ini-implement namin yung mga good practices options na yun.
Simple farming technologies were introduced, such as planting multi-stress tolerant rice varieties, intercropping techniques, and the planting of drought-resistant crops.
Almost every disaster na dumadaan, ang bottom line is family rin kasi yung affected. Dapat inclusive lahat. Hindi pwedeng si nanay lang nakakaalam, kundi si tatay lang. If we educate the child, at maganda yung pagka-educate natin sa kanila, 2 or 3 or 5 years from now, lahat ng tao ay napaka well-versed na to disaster preparedness.
The children are the most vulnerable. School-based disaster risk reduction programs were created. For each euro spent on disaster preparedness and risk reduction activities, about 4 to 7 euros, which would have been spent on disaster response, are saved. Disaster risk reduction is not only cost-effective, it also protects and saves lives.
At the end of the day, behind all these numbers, there are people. By investing in better systems, we are not only investing into the well-being of a country, we are not only investing in well-being of the economy, so we are actually changing the universes of little, you know, kids running around who have got their own dreams.